Mr. Carney, from a new member from Delaware, understand?
I am.
Been asked, you have 5 minutes to talk on this issue if you'd like to.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I want to thank the ranking member and the other members of the committee for the opportunity to testify today. I'd like to use this opportunity to offer some perspective about how the Antiquities Act was an invaluable and positive tool in allowing my home state of Delaware to become the final state to be included in the national park system. This happened just a few weeks ago when the President declared the first state national monument. The creation of the national monument will ensure that historic sites in Delaware and Pennsylvania will be protected in perpetuity. The first state national monument is a result of a 10-year effort by Delaware's federal, state, and local officials, led by Delaware Senior Senator Tom Carper and my predecessor, Mike Castle, to establish a national park within the state of Delaware. As many are aware, until the President designated the national monument a few weeks ago, Delaware was the only state not in the national park system. In 2002, with input from local stakeholders, Senator Carper established a citizens group to work with the public across the state of Delaware on ideas for a national park. The group put forth various themes and resources that the community felt could be represented in a park unit. After a subsequent resource study, the National Park Service under President Bush found that several of the group's ideas held merit. The Park Service supported a national park in Delaware that focused on our early colonial history leading up to Delaware's being the first state to sign the Constitution, which the current administration continues to support to this day. The Delaware delegation has introduced legislation that establishes a national park within the state every Congress since 2009. This legislation is supported by the governor, state legislators, and local officials. I want to thank Chairman Hastings and others on the committee for granting us a hearing on our bill during the last Congress, and I'm hopeful we can make even more progress during the next 2 years. One of the sites included in our legislation is called the Woodlawn Trustees property. This 1,100-acre historic property spans the border between Delaware and Pennsylvania and has been privately owned for public recreation for 100 years, once owned by William Penn and eventually preserved by Quaker industrialist William Poole Bancroft. The land is now a rural retreat for the 5 million people that live within a 20-mile radius of the property. Last year, the Woodland Trustees, who have been the long owners of the property, announced the imminent need to sell the land. Fortunately, a private foundation, the Mount Cuba Center, stepped in with an incredible donation in excess of $20 million to ensure the significant property would be protected forever and at no cost to the federal government. However, given the various limitations related to the management and transfer of the property, it was critical that we move quickly. Our delegation worked tirelessly to get our national park legislation passed before the end of last year, but although progress was made, we were not successful. Fortunately, the process for national monument dedication stipulated in the Antiquities Act provided the right path to achieve our goal quickly while incorporating public and stakeholder input. I want to express my appreciation in particular to my friend Congressman Pat Meehan, who represents the Pennsylvania district on the other side of the border, for his interest and support of the national monument dedication. Delaware finally became part of the national park system when the President designated the first state national monument. The first state national monument contains the donated Woodlawn Trustees property, three properties in the town of Old Newcastle, and the Dover Green. Combined, these properties tell the story of the role that Delaware played in the establishment of the nation, as well as Delaware's settlement by the Swedes, Finns, Dutch, and English. Without a path set forth by the Antiquities Act, we in all likelihood would have been unable to realize this tremendous gift that is the Woodlawn property. Furthermore, the Park Service was able to attain all five properties included in the National Monument without any cost to the taxpayer and will manage them using existing staff and resources. I will continue to press forward with the delegation with our legislative efforts to ensure Delaware becomes the final state in the Union to have a national park by passing our legislation. However, achieving the national monument status is a huge step for us towards this goal. I look forward to working with all of you on our legislation to advance it, pass it in the House and the Senate, and have it signed by the President. I want to thank you again for the opportunity to testify this morning.